Yeah.
Okay.
Right, we're on.
Put this over here.
So, what have we got?
Donald Henry Rumsfeld, born July 9th, 1932. American.
Most evil man on the planet.
Okay.
Charles is nothing compared to this guy.
That's for sure. He serves as the 13th Secretary of Defense from 75 to 77 under Gerald Ford. So 2 years under Ford. And then as the 21st Secretary of Defense from 2001 to 2006 under George W. Bush. So he is both the youngest and the oldest person to have served as Secretary of Defense. Rumsfeld was a four-term U.S. Congressman from Illinois, 1962 through to 69. He was Director of the Office of Economic Opportunity, 69 to 70, Counselor to the President, 69 to 73, the United States Permanent Representative to NATO, the most evil institutions on the planet, 73 to 74, and the White House Chief of Staff, 74 to 75. So he was born in Illinois, attended Princeton University, graduating in 1954. With a degree in political science after serving in the Navy for 3 years, he mounted a campaign for Congress in Illinois, 13th Congressional District, winning in 1962 at the age of 30. Re-elected four times, he was a leading co-sponsor of the Freedom of Information Act. Rumsfeld was reluctantly appointed by President Nixon to head the Office of Economic Opportunity in 1969. Now, why was he reluctantly appointed? You know, he's the president of the... And he reluctantly...
He's a top Jew.
Well, I understand. That's what I'm saying. So he was reluctantly appointed. The president didn't even
he
like
wasn't
him
a
or
Jew.
Want him.
Nixon was a Millerite or something. Something. He's certainly not a Jew.
Okay, so bottom line is Nixon was pressured to put him in.
Yeah.
It's
like the stupid Watergate thing with the taping. Here's you giving all these orders to the world. You're taping yourself your own crucifixion.
Pathetic. Okay, to head up the Office of Economic Opportunity, appointed counselor by Nixon and entitled to cabinet-level status. He would also head up the Economic Stabilization Program before being appointed ambassador to NATO. Now, 70% of the budget of the NATO nations goes into funding NATO, all their war crimes, bombing the innocents. Called back to Washington in August 74, Rumsfeld was appointed chief of staff by President Ford, recruiting a young one-time staffer of his, Dick Cheney, to succeed him when Ford nominated Rumsfeld Secretary of Defense in 75. When Ford lost the 76 election, Rumsfeld returned to private business life and was named president of G.D. Searle and Company, a noted pharmaceutical company, during which time he led the legalization of aspartame.
Well, through, I think one of them went on to the FDA to come because they change it every
year. Oh, it's a revolving door.
Yeah,
yeah.
Big Pharma, I think. I don't know if it's
to the FDA, yeah.
It might be something.
Oh, it would be. But the revolving door with the FDA had been going on.
It's been disapproved for like 20 years.
That's right. And as soon as he gets in, it's approved.
Yeah.
Bastards. Now, everybody out there, seek out the drug story written by Morris, M-O-R-R-I-S, Beale, B-E-A-L-L-E. It was written in, I think it was published first in 1947. It is the chronicle of the beginning of Big Pharma, Standard Oil, Rockefeller, and it follows, naming names, dates in history, This man who wrote it, Morris Beale, was an editor for the New York Times in the 20s, and then he found out, quick smart, that running with stories that highlighted alternative medicines, etc., soon got advertisers pulling their advertising bucks, including electricity supplying companies. That's the big threat that they all held. Yep, that's right. So he got out of there and then bought Columbia Press himself, so he'd have freedom to publish the truth. And in the 40s, he wrote the book that chronicles everything. And you'll see how the FDA, it's a revolving door between the pharmaceutical corporations, the FDA, and the politicians. And there's one evil dude, Fishbein, how he was the head of the FDA for years, that has resulted in today's FDA being no better than when he was there. It's all fact that he has chronicled. All right, Rumsfeld was recommended for the position of Defense Secretary by incoming President Dick Cheney in late 2000 and was appointed in 2001 by Bush. His tenure had been noted to be one of the most pivotal in recent history as one of the key individuals responsible for the restructuring of the military in the new 21st century. Rumsfeld was crucial in planning the United States' response to September 11, 2001. Which included two wars in Afghanistan and Iraq. Highly popular with the media for his outspokenness and candor, he gradually lost political support as the wars continued, and he resigned in late 2006. Mm. So.
Now, this David Icke, he came on the scene at one stage there, he's a very good footballer. But then he has some sort of a Kundalini experience, thought he was Jesus Christ for a while. And what he was doing was tapping into empathy with Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And he then went on a mission to expose it all. And just as we're